Hi, today I'm going to teach you how to install Centos 8 on dual boot with an already pre-installed Windows 10 and partition 2 drives, one solid state drive and one hard disk. I have unallocated volume for both SSD and HDD, 40GB of free space for the SSD and 480GB for the HDD. You can shrink space by right-clicking on the volume you want to partition and select Shrink Volume. Go to centos.org, click on Get Centos Now, and if you're going to create a bootable USB like me, click on Centos Linux DVD ISO to download the ISO image. You can find on the wiki page some tools that write images to removable devices like our USB. I've used RawWrite 32, just click on Download and install the program. After the installation, this window will appear and you can select the directory of the downloaded Centos ISO. Don't forget to set the file format to all files. Select the image and wait for the hashcode to complete. When it's done, you can verify your codes to check any errors during the download. I'll put the links of verification tools in the description. On the target box, select the USB drive and write the disk. When it's done, reboot your system. Don't forget to fix the boot order in your BIOS. Put the USB first, save changes, and reboot again if necessary. Now we can see the installation screen. If you're using an NVIDIA graphics card like me, go to Troubleshooting and install Centos Linux 8 in basic graphics mode. I'll make another video just for the NVIDIA drivers installation and you can watch that later on. Choose your desired language and click on Continue. You don't need to change anything on installation source, so continue with the software selection. I've selected a few and clicked Done. Make sure to set the network connection, you can select either cable or wireless. In installation destiny, select the disks you want to install to. As I've said earlier, I had non-allocated space on both SSD and HDD. Click on the drivers you want, change the storage configuration to custom and click Done. This will send us to manual partitioning. Before you start, make sure your partition scheme fits your needs and your driver's capacity. Personally, I want to use the SSD only as a boot device, so I've separated only the essentials for it. The HDD, on the other hand, will be used for other types of storage, such as softwares, documents, and temp files. Going back to manual partitioning, click on the Add button, select the mount point you want. In my case, I will select Swap. And for the desired capacity, I will separate 24 gigs. As you probably noticed, the number has changed, but we can fix that later. Change the device type to standard, only to select the right device. I selected my HDD and clicked Select. Change your device type to LVM again. Click on that again, select /boot and set the capacity. Click on Modify, select the solid state drive and click on Select. Now to fix the capacity number, type the desired storage again and click on the other partition. Add again, select /boot/EFI, set the capacity and click on Add Mount Point. Modify the devices and select only the SSD. Do this again with the other mount points available and don't forget to modify the selected devices. I'm leaving every device to LVM, except for /boot and /boot/EFI, and every file system to extension 4, except for /boot/EFI and swap. Now for the directories that are not listed, I'm clicking on the Add button again and typing the mount point I wish to install on a different partition. This time, I will type /usr/local and change the capacity again. In this case, the device was already set to HDD, so I didn't need to change anything. I've added another one for the /usr/share and /opt. Click Done when you finish and check if there's any error that should be printed in red. Click on Accept Changes if everything is OK. Now click on Begin Installation. Set your root password and click Done. Create the user and its password and click Done. Now wait for the installation to finish. Reboot your system, disconnect your USB and make sure your boot option in your BIOS is correct. Save changes and reboot again. Click on License Information and accept the license agreement. Click on Finish Configuration and wait one more time. Select the user and type the password to sign in. select the last configurations, and we're done. If you want to know how to install NVIDIA drivers for Centos, click here. Thanks for watching and have a good day!